Hola a todos, el día de hoy les traemos un nuevo video. Esta vez vamos a ver la historia de uno de los fangames más interesantes de la franquicia de FNAF, The Joy of Creation Reborn. Un juego que abordó la historia de los juegos desde un punto de vista único, al combinar hechos reales con los datos de la historia del juego. Así que, sin más demora, comencemos con el video. Nuestra historia comienza en el año 2036, con un hombre llamado Nick, el cual visita su antigua casa. Esta había sido destruida hace unos años por un terrible incendio, y después de todo este tiempo, por fin había conseguido los recursos para reconstruirla.
Really haven't changed one bit, have you? Tobias.
Hey Nick, the house. It's yours.
Finally, after so long. Thanks, man. It's been years. Decades at least, since I've been inside this house. I lived here when I was just a kid, with my family. My mom, my siblings, my dad. I received a call from Tobias telling me that they were finally ready with the repairs this morning. Took them long enough. Heh, it's funny. Even after what happened, and all that time away from home, it looks just like I remembered it to be. Is my memory that precise? Of course, things like the furniture and photos aren't here anymore, but hey, can't blame anybody for that. Right. I guess I better use that memory for something useful. I don't have the full story, nor do I know why it happened, but I can tell you how it started. Everything else is up to you to figure out. This is the story of the night I lost my home, my childhood, and almost my family. When Five Nights at Freddy's just ended.
Nos situamos 20 años en el pasado, en el año 2016, cuando Nick era un pequeño de apenas unos años de edad. Él vivía junto a sus padres y hermanos en esa casa. Una noche, cuando todo parecía tranquilo, un misterioso hombre apareció en el cobertizo de su hogar. Nick se dio cuenta de su presencia y le habló a su padre, pues aquel hombre parecía herido.
Hello? What are you doing in our house?
Dad, is the stranger okay?
Yes, he's okay. Don't worry, he just seems, confused. Excuse me, sir, can you tell me your name? Look, man, if you won't talk, I'm calling the police. You can't just barge into someone's house like this. Are you hurt? Do you need any help?
Honey, what's going on?
I don't know. This man suddenly appeared in our house. They saw him on the table, but I don't know.
Michael!
What?
My name, it's Michael. I'm Michael. You asked me that before.
Dad, and Michael kind of sounds like you.
Excuse me, just what are you doing in our house? The sun's about to go down. I don't think you should be here.
I was just saying that. You look a little bit roughed up. What happened to you?
I don't know. I can't remember. I'm sorry, but I just don't know.
Michael should get up. The floor is bad. Daddy, can we help Michael? Nighttime is coming. It would be bad to leave him outside.
I guess. Can you stand?
I think so. A bit. I just feel a bit... dizzy. Yes, dizzy.
Come on, man. Let me help you up.
Gracias a las insistencias de Nick, su padre ayudó al misterioso hombre. De repente esa noche, una gran tormenta comenzó. Se sentía un gran frío y la oscuridad inundaba la casa. Nick se fue a dormir, pero el misterioso hombre tenía algo entre planes. Los animatrónicos originales, Freddy, Bonnie, Chica y Foxy, estaban deambulando por el tenebroso bosque. Había rumores de que los últimos días cosas paranormales estaban pasando ahí, y ahora Nick tendría que lidiar con ellos, pero no sin ayuda, pues Michael no quería que el niño saliera herido, por lo que decide grabarle algunos mensajes y dejárselos en la cama, por si los animatrónicos van por él.
Hello, Nick, hey little Nicky, it's me, Michael. Don't say anything back to me, okay? There are monsters around that'll hear you if you do. Now, don't be scared, Nick, okay? Listen to me, and we can defeat those monsters, all right? Okay, so these monsters might look, surreal. Don't look at them too long, or you'll feel weird and see creepy things. When you do, turn on your desk lamp next to your bed. You'll feel safe there. But the more you stare at the scary monsters, the worse you'll feel, all right? Okay, first things first, Freddy, the fuzzy brown bear, he's at the window, Nick, he'll peek inside. Close your curtains and keep them closed until you hear him leave, or else he'll get inside. Then there's Bonnie, the ill-tempered big purple bunny. Keep an eye on your door, he'll be there. He's not shy at all, he will knock on the door to let you know he's there. Once he opens the door, shut off the lights as fast as you can, Nicky. Can't see you well in the dark, man. He'll leave. But make sure you're sitting down when you do that, right? Okay, then there's the chicken. That was a little bit weird. Check the closets often. She's peeking through. Make sure to disable the lights. She doesn't want to be seen, but ignoring her doesn't help either. If she does catch you with the lights on, she'll scare you and stun you. Now, look, I know this is a lot to take in, little Nicky, okay? Just listen carefully and try to remember it all. Please, okay? All right, last is Foxy. He'll be right beneath your bed, Nick. You'll hear scraping from the bottom of the crib when he's there. Be watchful if you see his hook on the back of your bed, because soon enough, he'll be right there next to the bed. Don't look directly at him, Nick. Instead, pretend to sleep. All right, just pretend to sleep. Yeah, just lie down without moving too much. Look up and close your eyes. Foxy sees eyes as if they're big, bright spotlights, okay? So if you pretend to sleep, he won't know you're there anymore. But don't open them until you know he's gone, okay? Okay, so to recap, Freddy is at the window, so if you see him peeking, close the curtains until he's gone. Bonnie will knock on the door and open it afterwards. Disable the lights and sit down until he leaves. Chica will try to stun you by scaring you, so if you see her peeking through the closet, shut off your lights and don't pretend to sleep. She'll think you're gone. And Foxy will appear under your crib and move upwards, so when he's next to your bed, pretend to sleep until you hear him leave. All right, you got all that? All right, good. Listen, I have to go, little buddy, okay? Just hang in there. They'll leave at 6 a.m., I'm sure of it. You can do this.
Nick logra sobrevivir a los animatrónicos, pero era solo el comienzo. Ahora ellos irían por el resto de integrantes de la familia, comenzando por sus padres, que estaban en la sala de la casa, asegurándose de que no pasara nada extraño.
Do you really think it was a good idea letting him stay?
Well, it's not like he was in any condition to do anything. Did you see his clothes? It's like he came out of a bonfire.
I mean, I could have... called an ambulance, maybe dropped him off near a hospital would have been better. I just don't think I'd feel comfortable with a complete stranger just ending up sleeping in our house is all.
Oh, honey, I'm worried about the kids.
course I'm worried about the kids. He's sleeping right next to them. How can I not be? What if he's faking, Val?
We could stay here to make sure nothing happens, if you're that worried.
All night?
Of course, all night. Come on, don't you want to spend time with me more? You are done updating your site for the anniversary. How about we just sit here in the living room and watch some TV while we keep an eye on the kids?
I mean, sure, I guess. Yeah, I guess we could do that. I just gotta go make sure one more time nothing's wrong, all right? I'll be right back.
Okay, I'll just stay right here. But don't take too long. You worry too much. What was that?
El padre de Nick se dirigió al cuarto de los niños, dejando sola a su esposa. Un grave error, pues los animatrónicos llegarían en ese momento. Por suerte para ella, Michael lograría ponerse en contacto con ella, hackeando la red local. Así, le podría dar consejos de cómo sobrevivir.
Hello? Is someone there? If anyone can hear me, please respond immediately.
Who is it? What in God's name is going on here?
It's me, Michael. Look, there's no time to explain. Just know that you are in grave danger. Is Scott there with you?
My husband? No, he isn't. He just went to... What do you mean I'm in danger?
Oh, no. Ma'am, I am very, very sorry. This is all my fault. You need to stay calm. I'll try to help you through this. Just please listen to me very carefully.
What?
Listen, there are monsters that are going to arrive to your room real soon. If they see you, you are dead. Do you understand that, ma'am? It is very important that whatever occurs, just don't let them see you. All right?
I know.
Look, just... You're in the living room, right? Try to focus on the three entrances behind you. The exit to the house should be locked, and they won't come through there. If there are any monitors nearby, then they should be forced to produce a camera system for you. Ma'am, is the TV in your living room turned on?
Yes, but it's filled with static.
All right, please keep an eye on it. It should help you. Look, they usually come from either the left side or the right side. You have nothing to stop them, so if you see one of them about to enter the room, just hide.
Hide? Hide where?
Just stay out of sight, okay? Yes, if they try to come in, just move somewhere they won't be able to see you, okay? Well, and I don't know which one will come from which side, but if you look at the TV, you might be able to tell by yourself. Maybe if you can, try to see if you can look through the doors, too. Windows? Keyholes? Yes, keyholes! If any of your doors has a keyhole you can peek through, keep checking it. They won't notice you on the other side, trust me. So yes, I can't stress this enough. If anything comes through those doors, hide. Just hide away from view. You might hear noises later on in the night. Pay attention to those. Don't look at anything that appears in your room and try to stay safe. Please.
Do I have to stay here all night? What about my children? What about my husband?
Look, it's very hard to explain, ma'am, and no, just wait until 6 a.m. to be safe. But don't worry, the time will pass much faster. Just keep an eye on the clock and wait for that time. They should all be gone in a few minutes, and then the hours will reset. Now, please, if you survive, I need you to grab your kids and get out of this house as soon as possible. I'm gonna help Scott get out of here myself. Don't worry, just please get yourself and your sons out of harm's way.
I don't understand. What is even happening? How do you know all of this stuff? Wait a second. How do you know my husband's name? I was there when he found you, Michael. He never said his name. How do you know? Michael?
La esposa de Scott, el padre de Nick, logra sobrevivir hasta las 6 a.m., pero paralelamente a ella, su esposo estaba teniendo sus propios problemas. Scott fue a revisar el cuarto de los niños, pero no los encontró. Además, en el ambiente se notaba que algo iba muy mal. Podía escuchar ruidos extraños provenientes de los pasillos, por lo cual, preocupado por su familia, los investigó.
¿Nick? ¡Nick!
What is happening?
This isn't real. This isn't real. I'm just dreaming. None of this is real. God. Freddy? Freddy. What are you doing? What are you Freddy? No! Oh God! No, what is this? Help! Somebody help! Bell? Nick? Anthony? Sam? Where are you?
Monsters are around the house. Here's your trusty flashlight to slay them with. We hide from the monsters. They were mean to Mommy. So we hid where you always tell us to hide. Much love, Nick, Sam, and Anthony.
Los hijos de Scott lograron escapar a tiempo de los monstruos animatrónicos y se escondieron en el sótano. Después de deshacerse de los Ignet, Scott decide ir por su familia. Scott baja al sótano, pero no encuentra a nadie. Dado a que los animatrónicos también estaban ahí, su familia había decidido salir de casa. Antes de reunirse con ellos, Michael decide hablar con Scott.
Hello, kids. Are any of you there? I found your note. Daddy's here. You must be really scared, but I'm here. Why are you doing this to us? Why? Just leave us all alone, you monsters! I created you. Freddy, Bonnie, Chica, Foxy. How is this happening? What are you? You are not them. You're just using their faces. What are you?
Your creation.
Usando las cámaras de su casa como distracción, Michael logra noquear a Scott y lo lleva hasta la caldera, donde ahí lo ata para dar comienzo a su maléfico plan.
You've prolonged this for too long, Scott. They're barely holding themselves together anymore.
Why? I have been a good man. We've been good people. Why have you demons come to torture me and my family?
I was saying that we've gone...
Stop ignoring my questions. If I'm going to die, at least I want to know why. Can you at least give me that?
Look, I'm sorry. It's just the way things have to go. It's just a part of life. For us, I mean. Their bodies are hardly keeping themselves together, so they've gathered themselves in the basement. They can't just kill you directly, you know. And I promised them I'd leave you to them. So I brought you here to at least try to talk to you before they arrive. So before they get here and everything burns, I'd like to thank you for giving us this opportunity to see the world through the eyes of your creations. Being Michael Schmidt has been an incredible experience. I mean, I feel I feel fantastic. I want to keep feeling like this forever. And to do that, I need you to die.
Leave us alone!
Scott logra liberarse de la silla y detener a la creación, un animatrónico amalgama hecho con los animatrónicos originales. Sin embargo, Michael logra elevar la temperatura de la caldera a tal punto que explota, incendiando el lugar. Scott logra salir de su hogar, pero ya no era el mismo. Su creación, Michael, se apoderó de su mente, destruyéndola y ahora convirtiéndose en alguien real.
Mommy, Daddy's coming out of the house.
Honey,
Carol, I'm here.
Daddy.
Oh, hon, I was so worried.
It's okay, Val. It's okay. We're safe now. Have you called 911?
Yes, I did. As soon as we got out, I called them, like, a few hours ago. They said they'll be here as soon as they come. Oh, God, you stayed inside there for so long. They thought you...
But I didn't. Don't worry. Everybody is fine.
Daddy, what happened to home? Why is it burning? Is Michael still in there?
We are safe, Nick. Murders. You're safe.
Everything's gone.
You are safe. That's all that matters.
Dad, you're acting weird.
You are safe now. That's all that matters.
Honey, are you okay?
You are safe. That's all that matters.
Daddy, no!
You are safe.
Oh my God, oh my God.
That's all that matters. You are safe. That's all that matters. You are safe. That's all that matters.
You are safe now.
That's all that matters.
See? They're safe now. Just as you wanted. Thank you for your cooperation, Scott Coughlin. I'll take care of everything from here.
Quiero darles un gran saludo muy especial a mis miembros Purple Sans, a Krusty Pancho y Constantino Vidal. Muchísimas gracias por todo su apoyo. También allá abajo en la descripción les dejaré el link a mi canal secundario donde a veces subo otros videos por si quieren echarle un vistazo.
Espero que les haya gustado mucho este video. Si fue así, pueden darle un gran me gusta para apoyar este canal. También puedes comentar cuál fue tu parte favorita o dar tu opinión al respecto allá abajo en los comentarios. Recuerda suscribirte y activar la campanita para no perderse los nuevos videos. Les recuerdo que ya está activa la opción de unirse. Con ella podrás obtener diferentes recompensas, como saludos especiales o ver los siguientes videos días antes de su publicación. Eso ha sido todo por el día de hoy. Nos vemos hasta pronto.